stand. Hallelujah. Christ is risen.
Christ is risen indeed. Hallelujah.
Thank you. But in every nation, anyone who fears him and does what is right is acceptable to him. You know the message he sent to the people of Israel, preaching peace by Jesus Christ. He is Lord of all. That message spread throughout Judea, beginning in Galilee after the baptism that John announced, how God anointed Jesus of Nazareth with the Holy Spirit and with power, how he went about doing good and healing all who were oppressed by the devil. For God was with him. We are witnesses to all that he did, both in Judea and in Jerusalem. They put him to death by hanging him on a tree. But God raised him on the third day and allowed him to appear, not to all the people, but to us who were chosen by God as witnesses and who ate and drank with him after he rose from the dead. He commanded us to preach to the people and to testify that he is the one ordained by God as judge of the living and the dead. All the prophets testify about him that everyone who believes in him receives forgiveness of sins through his name. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Hallelujah.
A reading from 1 Corinthians. If for this life only we have hoped in Christ, we are of all people most to be pitied. But in fact, Christ has been raised from the dead, the first fruits of those who have died. For since death came through a human being, the resurrection of the dead has also come through a human being. For as all die in Adam, so all will be made alive in Christ. But each in his own order, Christ the first fruits, then at his coming those who belong to Christ. Then comes the end, when he hands over the kingdom to God the Father, after he has destroyed every ruler and every authority and power. For he must reign until he has put all his enemies under his feet. The last enemy to be destroyed is death. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
While they were perplexed about this, suddenly two men in dazzling clothes stood beside them. The women were terrified and bowed their faces to the ground, but the men said to them, "Why do you look for the living among the dead? He is not here, but has risen. Remember how he told you while he was still in Galilee that the Son of Man must be handed over to sinners and be crucified and on the third day rise again?" Then they remembered his words. And returning from the tomb, they told all this to the 11 and to all the rest. Now it was Mary Magdalene, Joanna, Mary the mother of James, and the other women with them who told this to the apostles. But these words seemed to them an idle tale, and they did not believe them. But Peter got up and ran to the tomb. Stooping and looking in, he saw the linen clothes by themselves. Then he went home, amazed at what had happened. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, O Christ.
After watching the children's choir, I realized the women got to the tomb first, didn't they? For those of you who don't know me, by way of introduction, I was the pastor here for 10 years, ages ago, and I'm retired. And Pat and I have always been good friends, and she called up pleading. Well, not really pleading. She said, "You're going to do Easter for us, aren't you?" It's nice being retired. There are no meetings, no communion classes, no confirmation classes, no emergency calls to the hospital at the middle of the night, no nursery rounds, no Easter Sunday sermon, except today. When in the parish, the question was always, as Easter approached, what am I going to preach about on Easter? It's not easy. It's tough. There's lots of extra music. There's lots of visitors who, well, we won't go into that. Wouldn't it be nice if we could just say, "He is risen. He is risen indeed. Hallelujah," and let it go at that? It would be nice. He is risen. That is what it's all about. It isn't about Mary Magdalene at the tomb. It isn't about the mistaken gardener bit, which we know about. It isn't Peter and John running to the tomb. It isn't about John outrunning Peter. Peter probably ate a little too many pasta and couldn't make it as quickly. It isn't about the stone being rolled away. It isn't about the conversation Jesus had with Mary. It's about the resurrection. I have seen the Lord. He is risen. Beloved, it can't get any simpler than that. Jesus promised he would rise from the dead, and he did. Jesus promised that one day you and I will rise from the dead to eternal life. What could be a greater message? In the meantime, in between time, we are to be witnesses of that fact and to proclaim like Peter and John and Mary and the women and all the rest, he is risen. I have seen the Lord. Today we see the Lord in bread and wine. That's how he chose to continue his presence. Until we eat of that feast with him in heaven. Christians are Easter people. We bask in this feast all the time. Each Sunday is a little Easter. Our lives are a living on the edge of that message. So you see, it's simple. He is risen. He is risen indeed. Go tell others you have seen the Lord. Amen. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Church, let us confess our faith. We believe in one God, the Father Almighty,
heaven and earth, and all that is seen and unseen.
We believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only Son of God, eternally begotten of the Father, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, of one being with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us and for our salvation, he came down from heaven, was incarnate of the Holy Spirit and the Virgin Mary, and remained through him. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate.
He suffered death and was buried.
On the third day he rose again, in accordance with the Scriptures.
He ascended into heaven, and he is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end.
We believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, with whom the Father and the Son is worshipped and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets.
We believe in one holy Catholic and Apostolic Church. We acknowledge one baptism for the forgiveness of sins. We look for the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world. Amen.
Gathered around Christ, crucified and risen, let us pray for the whole people of God, the earth, and all who cry out for healing. Kneel as you are able. Renewing God, the good news of your resurrection changed the world. Give church leaders and all the baptized the same excitement as the women at the tomb and inspire us to share your abundant life. Risen Lord.
Hear our prayer.
Lord Jesus, as you made your promise of peace real to your friends and disciples, we ask that you also grant the peace that the world cannot give. We pray for the presence of the Holy Spirit to fill us and our congregation, that we may experience an ever greater sense of hope and joy. Risen Lord,
hear our prayer.
For all who seek you, that we might grow in our knowledge of your word, and so be strengthened in faith to love God and one another. We especially pray for our bishops, Elizabeth and Robert, and for all pastors. Risen Lord,
hear our prayer.
For all who struggle to maintain life and livelihoods in the middle of disaster, disease, and violence, and especially today for places in the world where conflicts rage, especially we pray for the people of Ukraine. Risen Lord,
hear our prayer.
We pray for security, hope, and deliverance, for those who hunger and thirst, those who are unemployed, for those in our lives who need your healing, direction, and strength. We especially pray for those on our prayer list, and those who serve in our military and their families, and all whom we name before you silently or out loud. Risen Lord. Lord Jesus, as you continue to reveal the truth and power of the resurrection to us, ignite in our hearts the fire of a passionate faith that we may celebrate the victory feast that never ends. Risen Lord,
hear us according to your steadfast love, O God, and in your great compassion. Bring us to resurrection and rebirth in Jesus Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Peace of the Lord be with you all.
And also with you.
Share the Lord's peace in whatever manner you can.
Peace.
pray. Be known to us, O Lord, in the breaking of the bread, as you were made known to the disciples. Receive these gifts and the offering of their lives, that we may be your risen body in the world. Amen.
Shed for you and for many for the forgiveness of sin. Whatever you drink it, do this for the remembrance of me. Let us proclaim the mystery of faith. Christ our Passover is sacrificed for us. Therefore, let us keep the feast. Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Thanks be to God.
Thank you.
Let us pray. We give you thanks, generous God.
For in this bread and cup, we have tasted the new heaven and earth where hunger and thirst are no more. Send us from this table as witnesses to the resurrection, that all our lives all may know life in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ, strengthen and keep you in his grace.
Amen.
Thank you.
Christ is risen.
Christ is risen indeed. Hallelujah.
You are the body of Christ raised up for the world. Go in peace. Share the good news.
Thanks be to God.
Easter practice is available to all.
And all the children meet in the narthex who will be participating in each egg.
Also, I have a key somebody left outside the sidewalk. They dropped it. It's like a house key, so if you're missing one,
coming back and see us again. Yes, he does. Okay.